I've done a biodigester that has been connected to a soakaway, the block lid one, and I wanted to show you basically how it was done. We did not construct the soakaway, but then it was assigned to somebody, some group to do it, and then we came just to do the biodigester and have it connected to the soakaway. So in this video, I'm going to show you basically how it was done. Let's go into it now. When you are constructing a biodigester at a particular location or on site, you have options. You have three options. You have the so-called pit option, whereby you bury the wastewater line and then you put stones and everything in it, and then you cover it with a rubber carpet or a black polythene bag. And then the second option is to have a soakaway done, whereby you have the top cover done for it, everything, and then the wastewater goes there and then it seeps slowly into the ground or onto the earth surface, depending on whatever type of soil you are meeting there. And then there's the third option, whereby you can simply have it connected to a drainage system or a wastewater causeway or a gutter, which one is available to you. And then the wastewater seeps through after the filtration, everything has been done. The wastewater seeps through and then it goes into the gutter. So the first thing that we did was to get the measurement right in terms of the pipes that are coming in, as the usual thing that we always do, have the gradient sorted out, and then have all the settings right. And then in this particular case, there was the need to have two pipes that are coming into the digester, because there was a toilet seat at the other end of the building, and then there was another toilet seat at the other side of the building as well. So then we have to do two pipes, two inlet pipes, and then one outlet that will be going into the septic system. So basically, just like I've explained, just like in other videos, I've shown you how to, the step-by-step guide that you need to construct a biodigester. You follow these particular steps, and then you have your digging done, you have your settings done, and then if you are using the precast slabs, you do have them erected, or if you are laying blocks, then you have it done nicely. And then you leave the leche pipe outlet, and then you have the 4-inch pipe or 3-inch pipe, depending on which one is available to you. You have it laid all the way to the soakaway. After you're doing the filtration and doing your biodigester bedding and porous and everything, then you have it connected into the soakaway. The idea behind this is that you have options like having it connected to a drainage system or a gutter, or having a soakhole pit done for it. But if you decide to do the soakaway, like I've also said in other videos, then it gives you a better, longer span, a better warranty, a better, longer lasting use of the biodigester. The main reason has also been that because the soakaway is such that you have laid blocks and then there's a top cover for it, you can have the water pumped out in a worst case scenario if it's not draining into the earth surface. Or if there's an issue, you can always have access to the soakaway. But let's say you do have a soakhole pit done and there are stones laid in it, and after construction and there's a problem, you cannot have access to it, because it's possible you might have done other works there. You might have done pavement there, you might have done other works there like tiling and everything, and then you cannot have access to the soak hole that you have done. So that's why most of the time it's recommended that you have a soakaway done for a longer use of a biodigester. So in this particular case, the clients understood it and then they agreed to have a soakaway done, and then the connection has been done into it. This water can be filtered, it can be used for other purposes, or it can be allowed to just seep into the ground surface. If there's an issue later, it can always be assessed and then works can be done on it. So basically, that's how you go about constructing a biodigester and having it connected to a soakaway. The next video showing you on the channel will explain to you how biodigesters work and how they are helping homeowners in terms of their wastewater management and giving them a better option when it comes to their toilet or human waste management issues.